Hey guys, I'm gonna go ahead and demonstrate how to use the 3D pen tool. I did give you guys a file of a sloper that's already been drafted, and your challenge is you're going to change it into a halter top. So we're gonna start doing that by using the pen tool. I didn't give you a POM measurement sheet. We're just kind of touching on the surface here. So I'm just letting you design any kind of halter top you want. The goal is for you to get practice, first of all, using the pen tool and then editing it. And then you'll, you know, cut the pattern so that it is the halter top. And then in our next video, we're gonna talk about how to fit it, because if you're gonna do a crossbody design, it's gonna need some contouring. Right now our sloper has ease in it. So if we just, you know, cut it, it's gonna gape and not have a great fit. So the next lesson in the next video would be about contouring and how to do that. So anyways, right now this one's kind of fun. You just get to kind of design whatever halter top design you want. I don't really care, whatever makes you happy. I just want you to practice using the 3D pen tool. So it's over here. I'm in the 3D window, by the way, right now. And let's see here. We have a 3D pen tool. Let's see if I can click it. I like when the name highlights. There it is. 3D pen for the garment. And above it, it has that little white arrow. So that means it's the edit tool. Below it, there's another white arrow, but that's not what we're gonna use today. Cause that's the 3D edit tool for the avatar. You can also use a 3D pen directly on the avatar. And that's really great for more form fitting items straight off the bat. I mean, maybe you could use that to design the halter top. I mean, it's gonna be really form fitting, but we're not really doing that today, but it is good to notice the difference. There's a 3D pen where you draw exactly on the avatar. I think this is good for, like, you know, bra design, if you're doing a corset, something really, you know, form fitting. But today we're gonna design with a 3D pen on the garment. So make sure you see the difference between the two. There's an icon of a t-shirt versus icon of like a dress form. So anyways, okay, so I'm gonna pick the one for the garment, and you really just click to get it to go, and it makes little vector points, a lot like Illustrator. To do a curve, you do need to hold the button. It's by the space bar. I'm on a Mac, so I would hold Command. I believe it's Alt if you're on a PC, and that will make little curved lines. When you're done, you double click, or I think hitting Enter or Return might work also. And then you can always go edit and change something. So if you're like, oh, I don't like that one anchor point, you can go back with that white, you know, arrow to edit it. Or if you're still mid drawing, you can even just hit backspace and it'll keep deleting all of them one at a time. So play around with these functions just till you get familiar. So, okay, so I guess I'm gonna do, let's see here. I'm gonna do kind of like a wrap halter on her. So I think I'll probably make it like asymmetrical eventually, like copy and paste it. Okay, I'm gonna hold down Command just so it's like kind of curved on her. Hopefully that's low, and maybe that's too low, I don't know. And then let's see, where do I want this to go? I think I'm gonna have it go above her bust over here to the side. I'm gonna right click to rotate. Oops, oh no, I lost my design. Uh-oh, let's try this again. Click, I'm gonna hold Command just to kind of, I'm gonna hit number two. I'm gonna zoom in. I'm gonna pan up. Okay, so I don't want that mark. I'm gonna hit delete on my computer, or backspace, I think, if you're on a PC. And let's see, I'm gonna zoom in a little bit more. Okay, I'm holding Command to kind of get a curve. Okay, I'm gonna right click. There we go. Last time I had trouble with that for some reason. Oh, her arm, right? Let's see if I can just keep going. Yeah. And it lets you go over different pattern pieces, which is kind of cool too. Okay. And then I'm just going to double click, click, click. Okay, cool. Oh, there we go. Okay. Apparently I didn't need to double click. So, delete. There we go. Okay, cool. So now I can get the edit tool. I'm going to hit the number two. I'm gonna zoom in, I'm panning. I could change it however I want. Right now, everything is selected. So if I were to move it, all of it's gonna move. So again, you just, if you wanna move one anchor point at a time, just make sure that it's selected, and you should be able to, like, you know, kind of adjust it accordingly. You know, it's like, I think it just takes a little practice. It's kind of awkward at first. Overall, I think I'm okay with it. I think I want to shave out the armhole though. I'm going to make it a little bit thinner of a strap. So I'm going to go back to the 3D pen tool. I'm going to draw another line. Let's see. Again, I'm eyeballing it. It's probably more common to have like a POM sheet to reference. But oh well, we're just having fun today. Kind of dropping her armhole to be a little bit lower. And again, I've been holding command just to get that curve shape. I'm on a Mac, so it's probably Alt if you're on the PC. Okay, what if I just click one time this time? Okay, I guess if you land on the first point, you only have to click once. You don't have to double click. But if you're stopping in mid-design, you'd want to double click. Okay, great. Do I want to change anything? Let's take a look. I mean, it's a little rocky here, isn't it? I don't know. You can always change the pattern too as well. Okay, so here we go. So I'm going to go ahead and select this whole line. The whole thing's yellow. I'm going to hold shift, see if I can do both at the same time. And I'm going to right click. And let's see here. I can just say cut. You probably noticed that I also had the option to trace as an internal line. You could do that too. And maybe you could kind of clean up the internal line on your 2D pattern. That might be a better way to go. Okay, so let's see here. I'm going to go and show both screens. Okay, so here we go. Now, again, this pattern is symmetrical, so I have it on both. So, okay, that's fine. I can deal with this. Let's see here. So probably what I want to do is I definitely want to delete this and this, but I don't really want to cut this side. So I'm going to merge this one back. If you hit the letter Z, you should be able to select both of those, right click, and merge. That's just one way to do it. I guess another way is maybe I could have not cut it and instead just change it to an internal line and kind of fix it before cutting it, possibly. Okay, I don't like that baseline. It bothers me. So I'm just gonna right click and say unlock all baselines. I did right click on the artboard, not on the garment, by the way. And then that way I can go get and delete it. Don't want it. There's two of them, even worse. Okay. Okay. So then let's see here. I'm going to pan over to this side. These parts are going to get sewn. So that means I would want this part to be deleted. So I'm going to hit the letter A, delete this pattern and this guy, and then come back here. Okay. And I want to merge this guy back. So let's see if we can do this. Right click and merge. And then right click and merge. Okay. And then let's see here. I have to unlock the, I guess I have to unlock the baselines again. What? Unlock. Okay. Really likes this baseline, doesn't want to delete it. There we go. That took a minute, but I won. Okay, it's kind of funny. I still have that weird shoulder dart here. You know, maybe that's something I just delete, but I also don't have to because lines up. It's up to you guys what you think is best. I'm gonna go ahead and look at this. But yeah, I could clean up the pattern on the 2D side. Maybe I should do that. That is kind of annoying, isn't it? So I'm just gonna pick the letter Z and I'm gonna zoom in. And let's see here. Yeah, I'm just gonna get rid of this point. I probably won't like that curve, will I? Let's try this. I'll do the pattern, get rid of that. Okay, and then maybe I'll just go ahead, right click to the pattern point, and then I'm gonna change it to be curved. Let's see if we can do that. Oops, let me zoom in a bit. Let's get rid of this baseline, we don't need him. Just feel like that's not curved. Convert to a curve point. Okay, it's a little bit better. What about this guy? Convert to curve, he doesn't need to be there. This baseline, I guess I can just delete because I don't really need him. Okay, so now the shoulder seam is 2.5 inches exactly. So why don't I also go over here and make sure you're 2.5 inches. Okay, it's close. I could leave it, but I'll just try changing length. I'm gonna type in 2.5. You can decide where you wanna change it. I think I wanna change it from the armhole. That armhole looks really curvy. I'll do end. Okay. Not a huge difference, but okay, so Do I want to leave those darts? I mean, I could merge that too if I really wanted. Right now, I don't know what I wanted. Yeah, I guess I should do that, huh? Connect that dart. Okay, so if I can close this dart, what's going to happen is that it's going to move it basically to be in the side seam. And maybe that's okay. So I'm going to go ahead and... Now, but they are different lengths, my dart legs. So let's see if this merge is going to work or not. Yeah, it still let me. Okay, cool. Okay, well, I have something to start with. My design is that I want to have two layers. So like one on the left side and then one on the right side. So it'll like overlap in the middle. So I'm going to see how this fits right now. So let's see if it will fit without falling off. I'm going to hit spacebar. Ooh, something weird just happened. Okay, there must be some weird sewing stuff. So I'm going to hit spacebar again to stop that. I'm going to get rid of these. I don't really need this open right now. And let's turn on my sewing. Yeah. Okay, so we need to get rid of this because I had that dart there, and so the sewing just stayed and hung out. Anything else? Should I be concerned? Is that good? Okay, I'm going to go ahead and spacebar again. Okay. So right off the bat, you can see it's really big. There is a lot of easing in this. So that's going to take us to our next step where we're going to practice some contouring fit techniques to get this to contour around her body and just fit a little bit better. But the point of this video is to introduce you guys to a 3D pen tool, play around with it. I didn't take that long. You guys might want to spend a little bit more time just familiarizing yourself with it. It is a really cool tool. So as always, if you guys have questions, let me know. And yeah, looking forward to seeing what you guys come up with.